Are you looking for a budget plate carrier? I may have the answer for you coming up on Fit and Fire.
Okay, go ahead.
Thanks for joining me on Fit and Fire, your channel for guns and gear and the fitness to run both. My name is Mark and I really appreciate you stopping by. As I said in the intro, you guys looking for a budget plate carrier? Well, I might have an answer for you in the Condor MOPC. It runs in at about $75 and so far it's doing fairly well with my AR500 plates. So let's take a look at it. Here we go. And just like that, you're in your plate carrier. Now, kid, it's just like any other plate carrier. Throw it up over your head and then strap it down. So this plate carrier is made with the 1000 denier Cordura nylon, which is very good quality for a low budget plate carrier. Most of them, you're not going to have that robust of material used for the stitching throughout the plate carrier, so it's going to be able to stand up a little bit more than its competitors for the same price. It also has the side release buckles on the sides and on the shoulders that you can use to quickly get in and get out of the plate carrier. The cummerbund here that holds the side plates is fully adjustable, or you can remove it completely if you do not want to run the side plates. It does have the MOLLE loops on the sides and the front, so you're able to attach any type of MOLLE equipment throughout. It does have the padded and vented material on the front and rear panels to help with comfort, some padding, and to be able to ventilate your sweat or moisture out as you are doing your training or your work through this. And finally, it's pretty heavy duty for the price that you get. It will withstand moderate and light use for, like I said, any type of maybe training that you're going to get into, such as like a carbine class or for home defense. I don't think that you could take this to Afghanistan and run it for 6 to 9 months and that it would stand up. It very well may, but I have not seen anything that would lead me to believe that it would. But with that being said, I have no problems in ensuring that this would do me just fine and running through a carbine course or a home defense type scenario. It also has a pull handle or carry handle on the back. So if you want to carry this to and from your truck, or if you're in a situation where you need to be drugged, someone can grab that handle and pull it. It has an integrated kangaroo pouch right here that you can open up the hook and loop style fastener and then put in magazines or a range card. I have attached the triple kangaroo pouch from Condor for the magazines. So I have 3 AR magazines and 3 pistol magazines hooked in through the MOLLE gear that you'll see in some of the B-roll. And that basically covers most of everything that I was going to discuss here. These shoulder pads here are fully detachable, so if you don't want to have these shoulder pads and you just want to run the side buckles instead, you can do that as well. So let me talk to you about the cons really quick. So this is a budget plate carrier and you're going to run into some fitting issues. I'm not a very large person. I'm 5'7 and 185 pounds, and the adjustments in the shoulder and the cummerbund are not done very well. I've had to improvise up here and then had to double up on the cummerbund. Basically, on the cummerbund, it's 2 pieces that comes together with some 550 cord. I've basically had to overlap them and then tie them together, and then as I Velcro them to the front, I overlap the panels to bring this in as close to the body as possible. The other thing too, with my body structure, my rib cage forces the side plates out a little bit, so they can't, just ever so slightly. So as you can see here, right there, my biceps are rubbing up against the top of the plate. Now, if you're running a 6x6 plate on the sides, you should be okay, but I have the 6x8, so those are rubbing a little bit, and it's a little uncomfortable. So that's about it. Those are the major complaints that I have with the plate carrier. I tell you, for under 80 bucks, you can't beat it, even with those slight detractors. Now, I bought this from Amazon Prime. The current rate on those is over $100. I'm not sure why price has gone up, but I did a simple Google search and came across this plate carrier at US Patriot Tactical. You should check them out. They've got a large variety of different tactical gear and items that you can look at. This came in at $71.99 on their website, and then they offered a couple other things with it as well that you can select on the drop-down menus when you're ordering. One is different styles of US flags if you'd want. Those run anywhere from $9.99 to $12.99. This flag in particular came with something else that I had, and I just threw it on here for good looks. And then they also have the hanger. The hanger is made of the same AR-500 steel that my plates are made with. They have been coated with like a rhino lining type of coating to give it some texture to help keep the plate carrier on the hanger itself. So you can just put it on there and throw it in the closet if you'd like. That runs $12.75, so that's an added bonus if you want to get the carrier and that hanger together. They do offer this in black, multi-cam, coyote brown, and then OD. So several different colors that you can choose from. Since I'm a Army veteran, I do like the multi-cam. I was able to deploy to Afghanistan in multi-cams, and really think that camouflage pattern is probably the best that we've had since the BDU style. So that's what I've got on this plate carrier. I'd like to hear what you guys have to say about it. I do understand that, yes, it is a budget plate carrier, and it's probably not for everybody. It's probably not going to fit very well for everybody's different sizes and statures, but for the price and, you know, an entry-level style plate carrier, I think it does just fine. I would recommend it to anybody. I would recommend heading up US Patriot Tactical or checking it out on Amazon. And tell me what you think. Hit me up in the comment section down below. And I'd like to see if there's any other styles of plate carriers you've tried and what has been the stories behind that. Are they successful trials? Do they fit comfortably? Or are they just pieces of junk? Tell me what you think. And just like that, you're back out of your plate carrier. So that's this edition of Fit and Fire. I really appreciate everybody stopping by, taking the time to hear what I have to say. Again, hit me up in the comment section down below. Tell me what you think. Tell me if this was a good review. If you are new to the channel, wouldn't mind hitting that subscribe button. If you like the material that you've seen, please give me a thumbs up. I really would appreciate it. Again, thanks to everybody stopping by and the new subscribers that we've gotten here recently. If you'd like to get notifications of new videos that I'm doing, hit that bell button. And with that, keep on dropping those bells and shells. Comes a high five for you. You ready? Here we go.